Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me show you how to use custom style sheets in Safari. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 900 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So when you look at a web page like this one, it's using two different things to determine exactly what the web page looks like. First, it's using the HTML, which includes all of the content like the text and most of how everything is laid out and designed. But in addition to that, there's something called a style sheet, and that determines what fonts are used, the colors and backgrounds, and other things. There's a lot of overlap between HTML and CSS, but those are usually how the two are used. Now, a web page like this will have one HTML page, but may have several style sheets. There may be a main style sheet for the site. There may be one specific to this type of page. It may be even one specific to this page itself. But you could also add your own style sheet on top of that, your own custom style sheet that will change how this page looks. It's not something most people generally use, but the option has been there in Safari since the beginning of Safari. So if you go to Safari, Preferences, and then to Advanced, you'll see here Style Sheet. And it usually will say none selected. But you can select one and assign your own custom style sheet. And that will change how this page looks. So let's use a custom style sheet here to get rid of the green and blue backgrounds that you could see here and maybe even change the color of the text just a little bit. To do so, we're going to have to create a style sheet, which is usually something done by web developers. We're just going to create a very simple one in TextEdit just as an example. So in TextEdit, I've created a new document and I'm going to go to Format, Make Plain Text to make sure it's a plain text document. Now here's where I'll create my style sheet. Usually you start with an element like say body and then you use a curly bracket and then you define the properties of that element. So for instance, I can do background colon and then use a color to assign for the background. So colors use the little pound or hash symbol and then 6 hexadecimal digits. So first two are red, second two are green, and the third two are blue. So all zeros would be black. If I were to put FF for green, now we'd have a bright green color. So let's use that as an example just to see how this works. Then you close the curly brackets and that's all you need for a style sheet. So let's try that. I'm going to save it. I'm going to create a new folder here called Custom Style Sheets. And just call this one test, but I'm going to be very careful to change the file extension from .txt to .css. That's for cascading style sheet. So we'll save this out. It's going to prompt us to make sure we want to use something other than .txt. We'll say yes. And now we have that one there. Let's go into Safari, Preferences, and I'll select that style sheet. And there it is. I'll choose it. Now, in order to get this to actually work, we need to quit Safari and then launch it again. But it's still not going to do anything. Why? Because our CSS isn't quite right. In that page, sure, we've changed the body background color to green, but the page is filled with different elements everywhere, and each of those has its own background color assigned. So we need to go deeper than just changing the body color, because the body is completely hidden behind all these elements. So we're going to put a comma here and say all divs, divisions of the page, a special HTML tag that's used throughout web development, that should also be set to green. So now when we use that and we'll quit and relaunch Safari and we see that now all of the divs now actually have a green background. But there are other elements here that aren't divs that aren't going to obey that. So how do we get everything to have a green background? Well, you could simply put an asterisk there and that will be everything. So now we'll quit Safari, launch it again, and we still see we haven't gotten everything to be a green background. What we're going to have to do is force a green background by adding exclamation point important. Because what's happening here is our style sheet is like the lowest priority, so other things are going to override it. But by putting important, we should now be the thing that overrides others. So let's quit again, launch Safari, and now we can see indeed everything is green. So let's find something nicer than green here. I'm going to go to html-color-codes.info. There are a ton of different websites that just give you color codes. And we can find something nice here, like maybe something like this color, or even something a little more like that. So that's F7, F2, E0. So let's go and set the color to that. Let's relaunch Safari. And now we get this light background here. Now we have a lot of contrast between the text and the background. So let's tamper down the text color a bit. To do that, I'm going to put another asterisk so it changes text everywhere. And just simply change color, which will be the text color, to instead of all zeros, which will be black, I'm going to do all threes, which will be kind of a gray. And let me do important and save that. So now we'll quit Safari and launch it again. And now the color is a nice gray and it changed it for everything, including the links. So you can see now I've drastically changed how this website looks and I can adjust those colors and make it easier to read. I can even adjust the font. So let's change the font to a serif font rather than a sans serif font and even make it larger. So here I'm going to use the asterisk again and I'm going to change the font family. And I'm simply going to state serif. So it'll choose the default serif font. I could do something like Times, for instance, there if I wanted to. I'm going to say important. Let's just do that for now. And when I quit and launch Safari again, you could see now it's a nice serif font. Let's make it a little bit bigger. I'll change the size to something specific, like let's say 14 points. And now we'll quit and launch it again. And now we can see we get a larger size, but everything's set to the same size. So if you really want to get specific for how everything looks on the page, you need to go to the Develop menu, which you may or may not have turned on. You have to go into Safari, Preferences, and under Advanced, there's Show Develop menu in Menu Bar. And you can look at the page source or the web inspector. And then with that on, you can select specific things, inspect element, see exactly what element this is. In this case, if I look through this and I know what I'm doing, I can see that this is an H2 here. So I could set an H2 element to be a larger size for that. It gets pretty complex if you don't know CSS and HTML. And the other problem you're going to have here is if you go to another site like this one, you can see it changes that site as well. And the results aren't always great. You can see here with all the backgrounds set to just be a solid color, all the graphics are missing from the Apple site. So it's not kind of ideal to have this set and just browse the internet with it. So you may be asking, is there a way to set it on a per site basis? And there is, but not built into Safari. You need to add a Safari extension. Fortunately, there are a few that do this, and there's even one that's free. So search for Tamper-ish in the Mac App Store, and you'll see Tamper-ish for Safari, which allows you to set styles on a per site basis. I've already got that installed, so I can go to Safari Preferences, and you can see I have it here under Extensions. I'll enable it, turn it on, and then there are a few things I have to do to set it up. It appears here, and you can see it says Folder Not Set. I actually have to run the Tamper-ish app, and then you have to set the folder where the style sheets would be. Fortunately, I've created custom style sheets, so I have that set up. So I will choose that one. Now in that folder, I've got my test file. The way that this works is you would create a subfolder and name it after the website. So I'm going to name it wikipedia.org. I'm going to take this style sheet here. I'm going to put it in the wikipedia.org folder. So now when I go in Safari Preferences here and I look under Advanced, it says none selected because I removed that file so I can't find it anymore. And you can see now things look normal. And if I go to any other website, you can see it doesn't actually use any special style sheet. But if I go to that one that's inside that folder, it is going to use that special style sheet. So the style sheet is now only for wikipedia.org. and it won't be applied to any other sites. So that could come in very useful, especially if you do a lot of research on the web and you go to a particular site all the time for that research and you don't like the font that's being used or you don't like the background color or something else about it. You can make it a lot easier to see and browse through that particular website without affecting any others. If you like this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.